Hi everyone, my name is Erin and I'm from Inside Out Ostomy. This is Dr. Garrett and he is here from Hilton Chiropractic.
Hi everyone, I'm here to talk about core exercises post-operation, post-surgery. With any abdominal surgery, we need the time to recover, and one thing that's really important is that we do have that healing time. But once we're out of that healing period, usually it's around 6 to 8 weeks, you'll get the okay from your surgeon, then it's usually the great time to start getting into good core exercises. So these are just a couple of tips on how to do some good core exercises from there and to basically progress you into full recovery. So one, a couple of provisos. As I said, you've got to get the okay from your surgeon. The other thing is making sure that there's no major abdominal pains when you're doing any movement. The one key thing here is that we need, when you train, you need to train properly. They say perfect practice makes for perfection. So we're going to do 2 sessions. This is one of the 2 sessions. This is where we're going to be lying on our back. So Erin, if you'd like to lie on your back. So these sessions, we're looking at switching on core muscles through your abdomen here. Now, as we said with surgery, particularly abdominal surgery, you're going to have scarring around your abdomen. So we want to make sure that that's not being affected by this. But we want to activate those core muscles. So, Erin, we want you to try and switch on these core muscles. Now, I'm going to show you how to do that.
Yep.
So first of all, get these 2 fingers here. Find the bony bits of your hips. So yeah, found the bony bits of your hips. Now just run in from them. Relax your hands down. So I want you to feel these muscles. We're going to do a cough here. Just give us a cough. Okay, good. And you should feel those muscles push out against you. Do you feel that?
Definitely feel that.
Great. So if you're feeling those muscles push out against you, then that's, you know, you're switching on those muscles. Now we're going to try and get those muscles to switch on, but not by pushing them out. We're going to try and pull them in. So if I can get you to, as though you're pulling your belly button into your spine, I want you to pull up from that those hip bones up into your spine. Do you feel those muscles switch on? So you should feel those muscles switch on as you do that. If you can hold that, that's what they call an abdominal brace. If you can brace like that throughout these exercises, that's exactly what we want. Okay, so you can hold it. All right, now. So, first exercise from this, once we've got that abdominal brace going, the first exercise we want to be able to do is actually get you to bend both your knees up. This is the least challenging of all of these core exercises. So while we abdominal brace, so pulling your belly button in, great, you want to just lift this one hip, one leg, about 10 centimeters off the ground. That's it, not so far, and then slowly lowering back down. Now through that whole time, you've got to keep those core muscles switched on. The best way to know that you're actually doing that, especially if you can't feel the core muscles switching on, is making sure those hips are staying level. So as you slowly lift that leg again, Erin, yep, you should be able to see your hips stay nice and level. And then back down, great. And then just relax there. Good.
Thank you.
All right, the next one. So lowering these legs down again, this is when you start to find that exercise gets really easy. So once you can start to do 10 to 20 of those and you feel quite comfortable with them, this is the next progression. Legs straight, same thing, switching those core muscles on, pulling your abdominal muscles in, then as you've got them switched on, lifting that leg straight up. Excellent. And you don't actually have to go all the way up like Erin's doing. She's just really good, overachiever, lowering down. So you probably just have to go up to about 50 centimeters off the ground. So just about there, that's excellent. And then lowering back down. The key thing is, again, is keeping this abdomen as flat as you can. Try and keep those hip bones as flat as possible. The flatter the better, basically. Excellent. So we do about 10 to 20 repetitions of that. If you're finding that's quite easy, up to about 20 repetitions, then we can actually start to progress to another level. Okay, great
time. Thank you.
So next one, no, staying there.
Yeah.
So now also in this position, what we're going to do now is a bridge. So we're actually going to bend both knees up, and from here, that idea of flattening our abdomen, we're going to actually progress to the next level. Just relax for a moment. So we do that abdominal brace, so we're pulling our belly button in, flattening our spine to the table, to the ground, and then I actually want you to lift your hips from off the table. As you lift, go one segment at a time up your spine till you start to get into a bridge position. The key thing with this is your abdominal bracing, but you're also squeezing your buttock muscles as you do it. Then once you get to the top, you hold for a few seconds, then relax back down again, one segment at a time. So you're just trying to push down each spinal segment, one segment at a time, all the way back down till you get your hips to the ground. Excellent. Let's try that again. Pulling in with your spine, lifting your hips, pushing up one segment at a time, holding at the top for as long, up to about 10 seconds, but probably around 4 to 5 seconds, and then lowering back down one segment at a time. Good work. Excellent. And then down and relax. Great. So if you're finding again that is comfortable, we can progress to the next level. And again, 10 to 20 repetitions. If you're feeling that comfortable in that time, then we can progress. All right. Ready for the next one?
Yes, please.
Okay. Now this last one, you want to be really sure that you're nice and strong in your core by this time. So this would probably be at least 3 months post-surgery. And you want to be feeling quite comfortable with all this, but because it's quite challenging. So again, we're going to brace in our core here. So we're going to pull in through the abdomen. But then what we want to do is we're going to lift our opposite arm and our opposite leg at the same time while keeping those hips nice and flat. So if you can lift one arm and one leg, slowly as you can, trying to keep your hips as flat as you can, and then lowering back down. Now again, it doesn't matter how high you go, it's more about that control here. So that's it, lifting and trying to keep it as flat as you can. Now you'll never get this perfectly flat, I don't expect that, but you're trying to control and keep that as level as you can. So even Aaron can't keep it perfectly flat there, but that's okay. That's okay. Excellent.
Come on, stay flat.
Yeah. Good work. Now, she shouldn't be breaking a sweat with this stuff, but she should really feel like she's having to concentrate quite hard. Maybe a little bit of a puff. What they often say is to mild fatigue, whatever that means. But mildly fatiguing your muscles. You don't want to ever get too tired with this, because it's not about how tired we make you, it's how coordinated we make you. Great. So yeah, after about 10 to 20 repetitions of that, you're feeling quite comfortable, then we can start to get into the big stuff, so big exercises. And we'll talk about that another time. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Gareth. Thank you. You've been listening to Inside Out Ostomy Life, and Dr. Gareth, from Hilton Chiropractic. Thank you.
Cheers.
Oh, awesome.